Hello friends, welcome back to BPharmaWise. Today we are going to discuss about pyrolysis of alkanes. It is also referred as cracking. And this reaction, pyrolysis or cracking, is of tremendous importance in petroleum industry because this reaction is widely used for production of gasoline or various petrochemicals or even the fuel gas. So what is this pyrolysis, how this reaction happens and what is the mechanism for it? Today we are going to discuss this in this video. So if you want to find it out, stay tuned with BPharmaWise. Also, if you're new to my channel, please take a moment and hit that subscribe button and the notification bell in front of it so that you'll stay notified as soon as I post a new video. So now let's dive right into the video and let's start discussing what is pyrolysis. So as the name suggests, pyrolysis, this word is derived from a Greek word, and pyro in Greek means fire and lysis means loosening. So, breaking down of molecules in presence of high amount of heat is referred as pyrolysis. This reaction of pyrolysis, when applied to petroleum hydrocarbons like alkanes, it is referred as cracking. Now, for cracking, the basic condition is you should carry out the reaction in absence of air. Okay, if you carry out the reaction in presence of air, then it will be a combustion reaction. What we want here is pyrolysis, and pyrolysis is nothing but thermal decomposition. So you should carry out this reaction in absence of air. So now let me take an example. For example, ethene. Okay, we will carry out the reaction of pyrolysis for ethene. Now, ethene when heated to 500 to 800 degrees centigrade in absence of air undergoes pyrolysis, and what it produces is a complex mixture of lower alkanes, alkenes and hydrogen gas. So ethane will give you methane, which is a lower alkane, then ethene, that is CH2, double bond CH2, and along with it hydrogen gas. So this is basically the pyrolysis gives. It yields mixture, complex mixture of hydrocarbons which are lower molecular weight, and it will contain alkanes, alkenes as well as hydrogen gas. Now, how this reaction proceeds? As I told you, this reaction needs very high amount of temperature, 500 to 800 degrees centigrade. Now, if you use a kind of catalyst like a very finely divided silica alumina as a catalyst, this reaction can be carried out at a much less temperature. And so in that case, the reaction will be called as catalytic cracking. Catalytic cracking. So basically the reaction is pyrolysis or cracking. If you carry out the reaction at lesser temperature in presence of a catalyst, then it will be referred as catalytic cracking. So now you have understood the reaction. So let's now quickly look at its mechanism. So, the mechanism of pyrolysis takes place in three main steps. As it is a free radical mechanism, you must have guessed the steps, because for free radical mechanism, there are three distinct steps: chain initiation, chain propagation, and chain termination. So, let's now discuss what are those steps. So, first step is chain initiation step. Now, in chain initiation steps, the free radical is generated or produced from your substrate. Here in this reaction, our substrate is CH3CH3, means ethane. I will write the reaction here so that it will be easier for you to understand. Ethane on thermal decomposition gives you methane plus ethene plus hydrogen. Okay, now see. In the first step, we should thermally decompose the substrate to produce free radicals. So in this case, the bond between carbon-carbon undergoes homolytic fission and you get two methyl free radicals. Okay, by breaking this bond, one electron will go to this carbon, one electron will go to this carbon, and it will yield methyl free radical. So in the first step, the methyl free radicals are generated. Now what happens in a chain propagation? Let's see. In chain propagation step, in the first step of chain propagation, this methyl free radical, okay, it will go and attack on the substrate molecule. Now our substrate is ethane. So I'll write it like this: HCH2CH3. It is nothing but ethane, CH3CH3. Why I have written it like this? For simplification purpose. So the bond between carbon and hydrogen is made up of two electrons. Now this bond will be broken and one electron and hydrogen will go to this, and it will form methane molecule, CH3, this electron, and hydrogen and this electron. These two electrons will be utilized to form a bond between carbon and hydrogen, and you will get a methane molecule, right? And in that case, this ethyl free radical will be separated. So you will get CH2CH3 free radical, which is ethyl free radical. Now, in the next step, that ethyl free radical, CH2CH3, I will write it like this, CH2H. Now this is the ethyl free radical. Now what it will do, it will decompose itself again, and this bond between carbon and hydrogen, which is again is formed by two electrons, will be broken. This electron will be taken up by this carbon. This carbon has already one electron, so this carbon and carbon will form a double bond here using this and this electron, and this electron will be taken up by the hydrogen, and it will be removed as hydrogen atom or hydrogen free radical, and in this process you will get a double bonded compound, which is nothing but your alkene molecule, and it is ethene molecule. Okay, now in the next step, what happens? That hydrogen which was there again goes and attacks on the substrate, which is nothing but your ethane molecule. Now what happens? Again, this bond between carbon and hydrogen is made up of two electrons. One electron, this will be broken, one electron will be left with hydrogen. This hydrogen with one electron and this hydrogen with one electron, they will form a molecule of hydrogen, and this ethyl free radical will be separated, CH2CH3 free radical. So this is how the chain propagation is occurring. In the first step of chain propagation, your methyl free radical converts to methane. In the next step, the ethyl free radical converts to ethene and hydrogen atom. And in the next step, hydrogen atom and this ethane molecule gives rise to hydrogen gas and ethyl free radical. Now these B and C, these steps go on repeating over and over again till the chain termination step. Now in the chain termination step, what happens is, now as the name suggests, it is chain termination step, means your reaction will be terminated. When your reaction will be terminated, obviously when the free radicals will neutralize themselves, right? So what happens is the CH2CH3 ethyl free radical will react with the hydrogen free radical, and they will form CH3CH3, which is nothing but ethane, which is our substrate. So this substrate can again go back to step number one, and the reaction will be continued like this. Okay, so this is the mechanism for pyrolysis or cracking of alkanes. So basically it is a free radical mechanism, and as you can see here, from ethane you got methane, which is a lower molecular weight alkane, then you got ethene, which is a lower molecular weight, or even lower molecular weight alkene and hydrogen gas. So this is how the reaction of pyrolysis happens. Now we have taken the example of ethane, which is the simplest alkane, right? If you take any other example like propane or higher alkanes, then you may end up with a more complex mixtures of lower molecular weight alkenes, alkenes and hydrogen. But now you know how the mechanism proceeds and how the products are being formed. So I hope you have understood the process of pyrolysis, which is thermal decomposition of alkanes. And when this process is applied to petroleum hydrocarbons like alkanes, it is referred as cracking. It requires a very particular condition like absence of air. And if you want to bring down the temperature of the reaction, you need to use a catalyst like finely divided silica alumina or one of a kind, that kind. Okay, so I hope you understood the process, the reaction and the mechanism. For more such videos, stay tuned with B Pharma Wins. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.